sweetheart? Oh, what's wrong with your face? Why did you leave that on your face there?
It's Christmas time, time for the holidays. That means families are getting together, and when families get together, that is a guarantee that one person is going to point out your acne, turn the whole focus of the entire family's conversation right on your skin, and that can be overwhelming. I know you know what I'm talking about. This video is all about what you can do to make that experience the least annoying as possible and give you some tips and advice that will make it a lot better so you have a plan. Okay, so first thing is first, there's nothing you can really do to stop grandma from talking about the blemishes on your face. I've been there a million times. So my first tip is be prepared. Because the older the relative, the more likely they are to point out your acne and be completely blatantly rude, harsh, and not sugarcoat it, which can be really hurtful. Now the next tip, which kind of goes along with that first one, is keep in mind that if you do have good relationships with your family, most of the time when they're pointing out your blemishes, your acne, they're not trying to hurt you. And I know that can be hard to believe, but if your grandma loves you, grandpa loves you, your uncle loves you, if they love you, then in their own dilapidated way, they think they're trying to help you, which is so stupid because they just don't understand. But they think like by pointing out your acne, bringing it up in front of everyone, and then giving you unsolicited advice, they're doing it because they think that they can solve your acne like this. Like it's just, oh, you didn't know to wash your face or something. And so it's coming from a good place. It's just coming out in the worst way possible and it sucks and it's hurtful. But try to give them the benefit of the doubt. Okay, next up is have a plan. This can help a lot because you won't be caught off guard. So just have a plan for when somebody does bring up your acne and then know what you're going to say, which you can either say, you know, I don't really like to talk about my acne, or I'm already working with my dermatologist, so I don't really like to talk about my acne. Or you can play the more nice role if you want to, and you can say, oh, thanks, great, I appreciate that advice, I'll try that. But having a plan instead of being caught off guard, getting nervous, having to answer from either a nervous place or an angry place, it's not gonna yield the best results, so have a bit of a plan. Another thing that can be really nice with having a plan is learn to dismiss yourself from the room. Because ultimately, if you're tired of a conversation, if you leave the conversation, everyone is going to inevitably move on to another conversation. And since they already brought up your acne, the likelihood of them bringing it back up again and again and again, if you just keep leaving the room, is less and less likely as you do it. I'd say that the polish on this one is learn how to do it in a polite and smooth way. You know, instead of like grandma points out your acne and she says, oh, what's wrong with your face? And just standing up and leaving, you know, have that initial canned response. Oh, thanks for pointing it, whatever. Okay, yeah, I'll take your advice. And then be like, oh, I'm gonna go get seconds or whatever it is. Oh, I have to go call my friend real quick. I told him I'd call them on Christmas. Whatever, get yourself out of the situation. That's always one of the best things to do, especially if you're feeling overwhelmed. Okay, now this next tip is maybe not a tip because it's probably not something that I would recommend, but I don't know. I just thought I'd put it in there because we can all have a laugh about it. You can be prepared to give them something back, a little bit of some spice, some fire. It's not really in my personality to do this, but if they say, oh, what's wrong with your face? You can be like, oh, I'm dealing with acne. By the way, what happened to that diet you're doing? You're looking a little bigger. Or, oh, are you starting to get some white hairs? I heard my friend told me that you can use super dark growth for men, whatever it is. It's not really, I don't think it's the most productive thing to do, but if you did feel like doing it, that would be a way to maybe point to them like, hey, when people point out things that are difficult to hear and are a part of your self-esteem, it kind of sucks. So yeah, Uncle Jebediah, your hair is starting to go a little white. How's that feel? Not that great, so stop talking about my skin, okay? Thanks, Jebediah. Disclaimer, I don't have an uncle named Jebediah. Okay, this tip is pretty monumental. I actually just talked to a friend about this, but have a friend or at least somewhere that you can vent to after the event. So if you have a best friend, be like, hey, my grandma always talks about my acne. I'm gonna call you up afterwards and I can laugh about it because she is so ridiculous. You get it all out. If you don't wanna talk to a friend, maybe journal, whatever it is. But I think the most important thing is don't bottle it up because bottling it up never solves anything, ever. So if you have a little bit of something you could do, it can help a lot. Now, probably the hardest tip to put into place out of this whole video, but something that can really help heal and communicate, and it's probably the most mature and high roadus thing you could do is talk to that relative or friend or whoever it is after the event. Once you can talk one-on-one and be like, hey, look, acne is something that's really hard for me to deal with. It really does affect me. It hurts me. I don't like being pointed out in front of everybody. I have a difficult time with acne. So when you put the spotlight on me like that, or when you give advice, it's not welcome and I don't like it. I'm doing the best I can. I've tried the thing you've said already. I've tried everything. And so sometimes you just gotta lay off of me a bit. Oh, easier said than done, because sometimes it's really hard to communicate with somebody that you don't have a one-on-one communication with, but I thought I'd put it out there. Ultimately, let it go. Whatever it is that anybody said in the family, let it go and focus back on your passions, your hobbies, the things that excite you and get you fired up and happy and loving and in the best mind state possible as soon as it's all over. So the next day, go do what you love and don't sit there and stew on it and think about it over and over and let that person crush your, you know, self-esteem and your soul. It happens. Things like that are going to happen. You are going to face people, whether it's in your family or outside in the world, who aren't in the most positive mind state and don't give, you know, any attention to what they say. And they're gonna give you some of their crappy, pessimistic, negative energy. That happens. So when that happens, don't suck onto that thought and attach it to you. Let it just flow on by and move forward with your life. We're all getting together with our family and our friends, and a lot of times when you're doing that, you break out even more because you're stressed about it. I know this situation, I've been in it before, so I thought this video would be pretty helpful, and I hope it did help you. Let me know what you thought in the comments below and add any tips that you can if you want to help other people out as well. If you are dealing with acne and you don't know what to do, or you've tried everything, try my acne program. It's theacnemethod.com. It is by far the most comprehensive program that you can do. It's 10 steps, 10 weeks. It's only 10 bucks. Tons of the viewers on my channel have seen huge before and after results. Look at that. It's in the link in the description below. And if you've seen my acne in the past, you know exactly how severe it was. I had very large cystic acne. And if you want to know what skincare products I've been using since I've been able to get rid of my acne to address my acne scars and get my skin really smooth, it's a question I get all the time. I use the entire Banish skincare line. That is literally all I use other than sunblock and Retin A. By far, I think the Banish skincare line is the best for getting rid of mild to moderate acne as well as addressing your acne scarring. I've been using it now for about a year and a half and I've seen huge results. My before and after is literally insane. So if you want to check that out, Brian5 will get you $5 off an order of $35 or more. I'll put the link to that in the description below as well. I love you guys. Remember, you are not alone. You are beautiful and you are a part of Team Acne. See you guys in the very next video.